It's your boy, Famous Animal TV. Who I got in the building with me?
You ain't know. It's the Chad Bish. What to do? I don't know. Got my brother Womack in his joint. Introduce yourself.
Key.
We got Rod. He the nigga y'all don't see. You know what I'm saying? You gotta have somebody face that you ain't see.
Hey,
you know, don't show your face, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, Todd, what's going on with it?
Oh, man. First of all, let me start out by telling you that, you know, me and my brother, we big fans of Famous Animal, you know what I'm saying? And I appreciate you taking your time out, coming to interview me and the fam, and you know, I appreciate that. That's a good look right there.
Real talk.
So let's get into it.
Real talk. So like I'm saying, like you legendary to the city, like. So like I said, is you still doing this music? Like, is you still at it?
Ah, man, I can't stop. You know what I'm saying? Even if I wanted to, the people ain't gonna let me stop.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I got, I don't know if people do know that we did the reunion album, with the Watch What You Wish album, with me, Paul, Lloyd, Coop, before Coop Day passed and stuff. So if y'all ain't checked that out, y'all check that out. Me and Boo got an album called Witch. I don't know if y'all checked that out, but it's out. Y'all go look at all the videos.
Yeah.
I got Murder, She Spoke Too out. So y'all go check that out and get on iTunes in the stores. I got Beast Mode out. That's on Live Mixtape. We dropped Dog Hallways, Womack. You know, so y'all just check it out. We're working. So I got Drama Queen coming.
1.2.
Yeah.
Is it coming out
new? I got Drama Queen coming in about 20 days.
Real talk. So like I'm saying though, like, where did it all start at?
Well, you know, basically, I've been rapping like forever, really, you know, and people that don't know, that's me on Chickenhead, that's me on Baby Mama, that's me on Two Way Freak, that's me in the Move of Choices, you know what I'm saying? So that's me, Miss Murder, She Spoke. Anyway, I started out with Juicy J, DJ Paul, 3-6 Mafia, Human Task Camp. I did some features with Tommy Wright III. I done worked with Yo Gotti on Whoop That Ho.
Who that?
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
talk. I work with artists like Gucci Mane. Y'all know, stick them up.
Yeah.
Starlito, Murphy Lee, Shauna. Oh, it go on and on and on, man. So, you
Criminal
know.
Mind,
yeah, Criminal Mind. Yeah. Shout out to Criminal Mind Squeezy. Shout out to all the Memphis rappers, man. Memphis is on right now. Memphis, we on fire right now. So, you know, that's pretty much where it came from.
Mm-hmm. So like I'm saying, like all these platinum like hits you got out, is you still getting paid off on?
Oh, yeah, most definitely get paid. I love to see them little CD baby. You got a payment going on, and what's that other one? Goddamn, shit, it's another one. Y'all know when y'all get asked a question, you can't answer right then. It's a sound exchange. Yeah. So y'all motherfuckers that getting them checks, y'all know what I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to SCM, Jay Shields, them. They the ones who hooked up for me to begin my royalties and stuff. So shout out to them.
Real talk. Yeah. So like I'm saying, like we go back to the like that barbed wire chicken. Like how did you like what made you just really go in there and just come up with like music like that?
Well, that was a Project Pat song. You know, Pat was the song did the chicken head. That was the first platinum song that came up out of Memphis and Human Task Camp. The first song to be playing in LA on the radio from Memphis. And shit, that really was my introduction to the world. And what I was doing, I was representing for the women on there. You know, me and Pat, we had the second verse. And I was representing for the women because these niggas be out here trying to holler at you and shit. And I ain't got no motherfucking money in their pocket. Around here driving their friend cars, acting like it's theirs and shit. You know what I'm saying? So I had to get on y'all motherfucking ass. You know what I'm saying? Pat tried to get on me, but he had me fucked up.
So what's it? Did y'all just plan that or did it just come out like that?
Yeah, once we did the chicken head, he was like, you know, because if y'all listen to all the CDs, me and Pat always argued on him. So he was like, man, we need to argue in the verse. So I didn't know what he was gonna say, he didn't know what I was gonna say. So when he dropped his, it didn't matter what the fuck he said, I already had him. I went in there and I laid it just like that.
Real talk. So like was you actually part of 3-6? Like was you?
Nah, I was Human Task Camp Posse. You know, 3-6 is made up of Paul, Juicy, Lloyd, Coop, Boo, and Crunchy. And Human Task Camp was like me, Frazier Boy, T-Rock, Project Pat, and Lil White, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And then they had the, who was MC Magnum? Killer Klan. Yeah, MC Mac. Yeah, MC Mac and Scan Man. And now they got the, now Paul got to see the seats. Real y'all called Donnie and Infamous on Lil Infamous.
Yeah, so like I'm saying, like y'all coming from the city and y'all legendary, you know. So like, by like the new generation doing music, like, do you have a relationship with like the new generation?
Nah, I ain't did nothing with the new generation yet. You know, like I said, in previous interviews and earlier talking to you, now my brother Womack, he took a fall three, four years ago. So, you know, I took a break. I've been taking care of him. I'm his nurse, so y'all need, you know what I'm saying? Nah, I'll take care of your hand, love you, baby. If you get hurt, hit me up. Anyway, nah. I've been taking care of my brother, but at the same time, we still been doing this music because the doctor said he'll never talk again. They said he'll never walk again, but God is good. He moving, then dropped the whole CD called Dog Hallways. I be promoting his shirts, Armstrong, y'all. Yeah, look them joints up, Memphis Live Matter. And, you know, that's pretty much my style. I put music on hold so I can take care of the family. You know what I'm saying? I had that situation. I got a lot of family first. Family always first. You can't do nothing if your family ain't straight. I don't see how people do it. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Real talk. So, like, now that everything is okay, like, is you putting your all back into this music?
Oh, yeah, I put my all back into it. You know, people already know I never stop. You know, I do the features. I be on the road. I'm booked all the time. You know, we got the Hypnotized Camp Posse Domination Tour going on. Got the Mercy Spoke Tour finna go on. And then, of course, y'all know I was just playing. We did do running challenge, and I just blew that motherfucker out the. Y'all know what was going on. Y'all knew I was gonna do that.
Real talk.
Soon y'all said, chat doo-doo running challenge. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Real talk. So, like, I'm saying, like, I had seen a recent situation online. I don't know if you want to speak on it or not, but, like, with the Cardi B situation.
Yeah, what about
it? I'm saying, like, was it a problem with Cardi B, like, doing her song like that?
I really ain't got no problem with Cardi B, you know what I'm saying? I just feel like a lot of folks taking Memphis sound, a lot of folks taking Memphis style. Yeah, I did do running challenge, and I had a subject. It ain't my fault that I had a subject. If a motherfucker would never say my words or, you know, anything that pertained to me, I probably wouldn't even have that type of subject. So I'm doing the wrong one. I've been reading up. I see the mixed class. Some people agree with me. Some people disagree. But at the end of the day, this ain't y'all. Y'all don't even do music. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? The ones that talk, y'all don't even do music. Y'all don't know what that feel like for somebody to be sitting up there saying your shit, your words, and all that old shit. And they don't even acknowledge you, period. They try to act like it's them. You know what I'm saying? That's just like a nigga going, doing his show just like you doing yours. Just like you doing yours. And no, you know that this is how you do yours. And he don't say, man, shout out for Famous Animal, man. You know, I've been checking their mind out. Ooh, ooh, ooh. That means you trying to run out with that like it's you. What a lot of shit. Folks was like, who was Chad? Chad's still alive. Chad's still listening. Chad can hear. I said I was the underdog, not underground, goddammit. I know what's going on.
Yeah, talk.
You know what I'm saying? I don't care if people be talking about she shouldn't have been saying nothing. I'm speaking on my part. I ain't speaking on nobody else's part. I don't give a damn about all that. I'm speaking on my part and anybody else that's trying to take Memphis shit, Memphis sound. Y'all might well put us back on the radio. The whole radio station sound like us anyway.
No, but
fuck it. They ain't got to put us back on the radio. Y'all just put our CDs back in y'all CD players.
Play
your
song.
How about y'all do that?
Real talk.
Right, play your song.
Memphis on fire right now.
Real talk. So, like, do you think, like, the legendary people from the city and shit, like, they get the credit they deserve?
Really.
By the new generation coming and doing music and shit like that?
They should.
Rapping off like the beats y'all rapped off, like, you know, and things like that back in the day?
I think they need to show more homage, man. You know, it's real talk. You know, disrespect to the young people because they good. I'm on some of it. But, you know, just show homage to where it comes from, man. You know, and then just learn the history about the M-Town. Because, man, we've been on fire. We still... You know, they can take the torch and take them apart in what we're doing now. You know, it's already going down. So it's just like, just a little more humble. You know, just be humble, man. Then, you know, take the time, do your thing.
The crazy part is, I know they know the history or they wouldn't even be fucking with the songs. So they know the history.
They're doing a lot of rewrites. You know, you can just take people's songs and make a whole hook out of it.
Real talk.
No, we start, I mean,
but we ain't mad at you.
We ain't mad. We just, it's big business, baby.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It just got to be a little more respect, man. Man, just show them all the homage, man. You know, that's all. Because I'm still, I respect the people from Paul. I'm still a fan. You know what I'm saying? My sister rap. I still respect Depot like I just met Depot, and they know nigga not well, man. Okay, just love because there's a real situation going on. And I just respect how a nigga come. I ain't never trying to be in the way. I'm just dirt playing my role, you know what I'm saying? I didn't know what it was.
In the 90s,
you know, it's different, but because it was more respect. That nigga, I'm sitting there just like, everybody want to be seen all in a video. You know what I'm saying? Y'all get this shit out, man. Man, sit back, man. The light gonna hit you anyway. You know what I'm saying? You shine, you gonna shine.
Yeah, and much love to all the legends in Memphis, man, and all the rappers in Memphis.
Yeah, I'm telling you, much love.
Because a lot of people don't know, you know, Memphis, we got our own slang. You know, we do. Can't nobody sound like Memphis. Can't nobody walk like Memphis. Can't nobody talk like Memphis. You know, we all do the same shit. That's one thing about it. We can go out of town. We can't take this Memphis out of us. We can bring this Memphis with us, but we can't take it out of us.
Banging on the nigga out of town.
And then everywhere we go, they love Memphis. They love Memphis.
No, Memphis, we banging on nigga out of town on our own shit.
Real talk.
I mean, it's just real honest, man. You gotta get, so you know, here ain't nobody Memphis going. Ain't nobody no holy respect. Man, you gotta give it to get it, man. That's all we just saying, man. You know, we city, man. Everybody know they got that sound from, man. You know, Lord, Poop, Skinny. You know, a lot of this shit they brought
up. We get to doing the nine call. We're going to forget some back.
You're right.
But much love to everybody.
Them guys, you know, a lot of people that nigga just, you know, up on though, that we know that, you know, it was already stamped to prove, you know what I'm saying? So,
yeah,
love the city, man. We just love what you do, man. We hope we get more stars about this jump, man.
Real
talk. You know, and stop the hating, you know what I'm saying? And all that extra murder, man, we ain't doing no beef. You know, we gunning. Man, Memphis was gunning down city, man. You cross the gun line, you getting it. Mm-hmm. In the battle, man. We got to come together. Memphis loud matter, bro.
Real talk. So, like, who are some of the people you still have relationships with now to this day? Wait. You still got the relationship with Pat and all them?
Yeah, we on the road now. We on the Hematized Camp Posse tour. You know, I still talk to Pat, Paul. I ain't talked to Juice in a minute, but I got White, Frazier. Rest in peace, Lord. Rest in peace, Coop. You know, we still out. You know, trying to make it happen, getting this money.
I
got Drummer Queen dropping. Got some production from Squeaky. Shout out Lil Loaded too, because I got some Lil Loaded production on there too. Danny Boy, he's an upcoming young producer. Shout him out too. And I need to get over Memphis Track Boys because I need to get some from them. Yeah, Dirk Jones, he a producer on there too. So I don't want to leave nobody out because when that motherfucker drop, I want y'all to know. You know, I gave him a shout out.
You know, I gotta ask you, like, by you being a female and things like that, what made you go get some goals?
Cause you know, just go with my dark skin, gold teeth, you know what I'm saying? That's just, I don't know, what made me go do it? Once I started getting them, I think I started off with like 4. And then after that, the next week, I just said, fuck it, I'm finna slug it on out.
Got
6, and then, And then, you know, by me having a big smile, that what made them stand out the most. And, you know, I loved it. I don't think I ever changed. I'm gonna be getting my dentures gold, goddamn.
Real talk.
Just go with my gold, my chocolate skin.
Real talk. So, like, is your music, like, is you still, like, giving out the same sound you was giving out back then?
Yeah, I'm giving it out. Like I said, we got Drummer Queen coming. I got my man production from Squeaky, Zerk, DJ Paul. Who else got me?
Is it on that crunk shit?
Man, you already know, man. On this gangster shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like I said, a lot of people don't have respect for gangster rappers. Gangster female rappers out there. But it is what it is, man. Y'all got to respect that shit because there's gangster bitches out here, too. The penitentiary full of bitches, too. You know what I'm saying? So, gangster bitches get down with the get down. Everybody can't be barbers. Everybody can't be pretty. You got the business bitches. You got the freaky bitches. You got the baddest bitches. You got the scary bitches. And you got the gangster bitches. You know what I'm saying? And you got the hood bitches. You know what I'm saying? So, somebody got to represent for them, and I'm their bitch. You know what I'm saying? And gangster can be gangster. I'm going to be real. I ain't never been in jail. Never in my life. You know why? Because I'm too gangster for that shit. I do what I do and I get away with that shit. You know what I'm saying? I think that shit out and I do it. Everybody know me. I ain't no motherfucking angel.
Yeah, so like coming up, growing up in Memphis and shit like that, do you feel as though like doing music or rapping is the first way to get out the street? Is the quickest route?
Yeah, I feel like it's a quick way, but the rap game to me still just like the streets. You know what I'm saying? You still got the niggas throwing crosses. You still got the hating. You still got the competition, motherfuckers competing and shit. A motherfucker still blow your ass off about this rap shit. A motherfucker still get on your ass about this rap shit. And you get money in it. So really, the rap game is still like the street game to me. So I really say, nah, I'm telling young folks, nah, get a job. You know, go to school, go do something else productive and use rapping for a hobby. And then if it blow, it blow. You know, a lot of people don't even work trying to make this rap shit their main priorities. But I'm going to let you know you're losing your way because you got to already have you some money going because this shit costs. You got to spend money to make money. Because the only way you're going to make some money out here, you got to spend it to make it. So get your money up, use the rap for a hobby, man, and promote yourself. Can't nobody promote you better than you. Don't depend on no label. Don't depend on no manager. Don't depend on your family or none of that. If it's you that want to go somewhere, man, you got to do what you got to do for you. And that's in anything, not just the rap game, in all the games.
Real talk, real talk. So, like, coming up from Memphis, do you feel as though, like, most of the new generation got it easier than the way y'all had it by being, you know, having the internet and all that?
They got it so much easier. First of all, 12 bars now. Goddamn, we had to do 16 to 20 bars. Now you can do 12 bars. That's considered a first. They ain't not bad. I can do 12 bars.
Eight.
Yeah, some of them do eight. Bars. They got the social media. And I ain't hating on social media because I get plenty of money off social media. Goddamn. So, but they got the social media.
I ain't
got
to do the hate.
Mine, they got all that shit. And we ain't had none of that shit growing up. No, none of that shit when we was out. We ain't had none of it. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, it's very, very, very easy, like very convenient.
The tapes were the bricks, man. We had the book bag for them done at the fair round.
Real talk.
DJ Feli, shout out, man, rest in peace DJ Feli, man, DJ Pinky, shout out to them.
Yeah.
We could be tape selling dogs out there. Yeah, man, like $10. Don't put it in your car right now, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes you just give it out, man.
Hey.
I don't think folks know, you know, we were growing up, and then they got the radio. See, we were growing up. And we were trying to get our grind on out here. We had to give our shit away. We ain't know nothing about no mainstream music at all. We were bumping DJ Squeakers, the DJ Zerk, the Tommy Rice, Juicy J's, the Paul, the Tiny Mind, the Criminal Mind, Spanish Fly, Pretty Tony, you know what I'm saying? We ain't Al Capizzi, man, what Tomsky, all that shit. We ain't know nothing about the mainstream. Whoever mainstream, we didn't know. Because Memphis had Memphis on lock. That's when the real support was going out. You know, now everybody be just caught up with everybody's shit. I don't even think Memphis motherfuckers play Memphis motherfuckers like they should. Man. You know what I'm saying? They be so caught up trying to be everybody else and do what everybody else doing and not even supporting the Memphis rappers. But out of town, they love Memphis motherfuckers, I swear to y'all. So we be good anyway.
We don't
even be mad at y'all, Memphis. We don't be mad. You can see people say, what's y'all favorite artist? They don't never say no Memphis rapper. And y'all know we got something to hide in. Y'all ain't got to say my name. I don't give a damn about that, but y'all know we got some of the hottest rappers in the industry right now. And y'all are still put somebody else's name before y'all put a motherfucking name that's in Memphis. Some that's crazy. But that's Memphis shit. That's us. I ain't gonna say it's Memphis. It's us.
So the hate been going on for like since back then.
Yeah, the hate ain't been going on since back then. So, to answer the question, no, the rap game is not the quickest way to get out of the streets, man. Y'all go to school or go get y'all a job somewhere and use the rapping for a hobby. Because rapping is not guaranteed, but it is guaranteed to break your pockets.
Mm-hmm. The other thing, you know, sometimes people be taking the rap so serious, they trying to live that rap life, they end up excelling themselves to their death because they're trying to be that person that they rapping about. You know, sometimes you got to be yourself, though. When you're doing the music, it's okay, it's entertainment, and then it's you. You know what I'm saying? She said it ain't the fastest way because when you start trying to live life, people out of town think you that person. Then guess what? You gotta blow up on that. Oh man, I think he ain't about that life.
But it is a major come up now. If you do get in the rap game, it's a major come up.
So like, let me ask you, like, is you signed?
Oh no, I'm not signed. I got my own label called Dime a Dozen. You know, thank you, I ain't signed. That mean I can do what the fuck I want to, because I ain't signed, you know.
So, is you willing to take a deal, like, to this day?
Man, not these days, man. I don't see what the deal's doing. Man. We ain't got BET up no more. Oh, shit. Everything flowing on YouTube. Goddamn, you got the live mixtape. You got the iTunes. You got the Spotify. You got all that shit. Matter of fact, you just got to do some distribution yourself. So, you really don't really need no deals these days. You ask me. Because that shit ain't going to do nothing but give you a big upfront money And then you be sitting on that upfront money, living off of it. I don't see where they pushing you with.
Yeah, that,
you gotta push
yeah,
yourself. Yeah. They go back to push yourself. Don't depend on none of that.
Do that. Put posters out and
Yeah, man.
Then niggas took that crap to the heart, though. You know what I'm saying? I know niggas just get on there. I'm just playing, bro. Get the and get a hit off this shit.
My what?
The beat beats mad. You know, when niggas be on the beat, we ain't checking out what the fuck they talking about.
Real talk.
It's just a grind, man. You know, if you do it, though, now put your all into it, though. That's all we just saying, though.
Real talk.
Man, I'm about somebody listening. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. 1 or 2 to 32 people. You hear me?
What's
you got somebody. You get a fan base, man. You just keep going with what you starting off again. You know what I'm saying?
Real talk.
Stay humble, man. You know, that's all.
Yeah.
Simple shit, respect.
So, like, did you ever think about, like, remixing, like, bringing all them hits you got out, like, back to life?
I just redid Slide on My Cat. So, DJ Zerp produced the beat. So, yeah. And I think that's going to be my next single. If I can ever get them to give me a good mix on it, Zerp, I just text your ass and told you I need the clean version to Don't Stop. Slide on My Cat 2, 2018.
Real
we gonna
talk.
Get it though. When y'all get this shit gonna be packed. But other than that, I don't think I'm gonna remix nothing else, you know. I'm gonna just bring it. I'm gonna just get y'all this shit.
Real talk. So, like, man, go on, let them know where to follow you at and what to be expecting next from you.
Okay, well, y'all can follow me on Twitter. It's at The Realer Chat. That's D A R E A L L A C H A T. My IG is Lil Chat. L-A-C-H-A-T, not L-I-L, but however y'all want to do it. But the real way is L-A-C-H-A-T underscore I-G. My Facebook, my government name, Chastity Dance. Chastity Dance. Don't tell the police. And what else? Snapchat. What the fuck my Snapchat is? Lil Chat Rap, I think. I don't know what the fuck my Snapchat is. I don't even know how to use that shit. I don't like that. Take a picture, disappear. I don't like that magic ass shit. You know what I'm saying? So, Snapchat, I'm on there though. But if y'all find me, that's me. Lil Chat underscore 38. So, that's pretty much. If there's anything else I need to get on, y'all tell me. Because I don't know nothing about that shit. I'm a hood bitch. I'm a street bitch. I just got into the Androids. I went from the flip phone because they made me go from it. Other than that, I ain't give a fuck about this shit.
Yeah.
That being real.
To get these shirts here, man, and new music. Y'all hit me up at Womack, you know what I'm saying? Womack, they're home, and you put W-O-M-A-C-C now. Mac, you know what that, you know, W-O-M-A-C, no K. We ain't doing no K's on nothing. But you know what I'm saying? And y'all hit me up, man, $10. Sure, y'all look for features. Man, you know, my nigga doing beats.
And your IG.
IG, Womack,
underscore,
the Omen. You know what I'm saying? And that's
Facebook.
Facebook, Womack, the Omen. Everything Womack, the Omen, W-O-M-A-C. D-A, you put W-O-M-A-C-C, it'll pop up.
Mm-hmm.
And man, you know, if you want the shirt, man, hit me up, man. I got the $10. We ain't even trying to butt your head. We just trying to represent Memphis, man, and you got something, I'm strong, you know. That's what everybody who survived the situation or been through something, man. Mm-hmm. You got something to show, man. You say it with a shirt. You ain't got to talk to a nigga. Nigga just, I'm strong.
Real talk.
Because, man, hey, life real, man. I'll take another granted, man. Hit me up, man. I got you. Even if you ain't got the money, man, you got about $5-$6. I'll fuck with you.
Yeah, hit me up, man. Like, damn, then get that shit. It's like I'm doing Drama Queen. I can put it on iTunes if I want to. But, you know, I'm so legendary, I'm going to get that shit away. So, just so y'all can see. Nah, I'm going to get that shit away. So, once again, like I said, for those that don't know what I got out lately or what I've been putting out, we got the Watch What You Wish, you know, the reunion album, the Mafia 6, so y'all can check that out. Me and Boo got the Witch album. We got Murder She Spoke 2 out. We got Beast Mode Live Mixtape. And we got the Dog Hallways out. And we got Dog Hallways 1.2 coming out. And we got Drama Queen coming out. So y'all be looking out for that shit. Plenty of videos on the YouTube. Yeah. Y'all subscribe to it at The Real Lil Chat on YouTube. And what's on YouTube?
Oh, man, I'm with W-O-M-A-C-C, man.
Yeah.
I just got on it, so, man, y'all got to boost me up. I'm a little now, so I'm a little dog. I'm trying to stomp with the big dog, Tommy. But I'm trying to get in. You hear me?
Yeah.
Me up, and, man, I put a video on there every day, man. Niggas just start tapping in.
Yeah, once again, Animal, I appreciate you coming out here. Yeah, you know,
Animal, man,
shout out, y'all subscribe to this jump right now.
Man.
Hit the,
Hit the like button.
Hit the like button, and y'all subscribe to this man channel right now. He gonna keep y'all updated with all the latest tea, gossip, truth, what's real, what's not real. All that shit. He a Memphis nigga.
I mean, in Miami.
Come on, now y'all know what's going on.
In Miami, Jacksonville.
Hey, so y'all support the Memphis bloggers. Yeah. Support the Memphis bloggers, Famous Animal Man.
Shout out to Mississippi too, man. I see y'all doing y'all thing, man. Y'all keep doing that. Man, RIP to Lil Lonnie over there, man. You know, sound like a good guy, heard his music, man. Tight, man. You know, we got to do a lot better on all this murder, but you know. Shout out to anybody that's trying to get money in the music industry, period, though.
For sure.
For real, man.
Much love. Y'all stay tuned to Famous Animal. Y'all stay tuned to Lil Chad and Womack. You know what I'm saying? It's going down. Memphis 10, baby. Y'all know I don't got to do no shout outs. I love y'all.
MTL, man.
I don't want to forget nobody. Fuck that shout out shit. I ain't doing it. But y'all know who y'all is. I love y'all.
You bitches want my style. Here it go, here it is. Yeah, you know why I get down. To the fight, I'm the real. I've been gone for a minute. Now I'm back, trying to get what you hoes wanna do. Either way, I'm up on it. We can take it to the street or the beat, how you want it. Yeah, they label me the champ, and I call you the opponent. I'm the plug in this shit. While you hoes getting fronted, it don't matter what it is.